Hi guys, we got two Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 with us, and believe it or not, we got a hold of the 256 gigabyte version with 8 gigabyte of RAM, and you have the
128 gigabyte with 6 gigabytes of RAM. And we want to help you make the decision which of these two devices is best for you.
You know what that means? A lot of number crunching, Geekbench, gaming, Microsoft Office application opening, real life performance. You can make that choice by the end of this video, which one is for you. If you are new to our channel, we do tech reviews. We do awesome tech reviews. Jens here from Alsa Space.
Toni the car
key. For our one-to-one comparison of the Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 devices, I want to make sure that I expose both tablets to their fullest. I am using an app called Droid Info, which reads all system information and displays them back nicely. On the left, you will find the 8 GB version, and on the right, the 6 GB version. The only difference within the device info is the baseband and RIL version. This is the difference between an LTE version and a non-LTE version. Both have the same 1600x2560 display and a refresh rate of 60Hz. A question that came up loads in the comments for our previous Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 full review video. The system info shows the chipset and the architecture. Both have 8 cores and a Snapdragon 855. The unofficial name, however, for the Snapdragon 855 is SM8150, which you can see right here. In terms of graphics, both have Adreno 640 installed. Memory is obviously the biggest difference here, and you can see the 8 GB RAM versus 6 GB of RAM, and of course the difference in internal storage. Once you inserted a micro SD card, you will be able to see this info here as well. And there is no surprise. The cameras are identical, as well as Bluetooth and the wireless chipset. Neither devices support NFC technology.
So the next thing we tested was the opening of the Microsoft apps. We must have run through this at least 10 times.
Minimum.
And on almost every single occasion, the smaller device, the 6 GB of RAM, was a touch slower.
Yes, that's exactly how I felt as well. And just touching it, it's just, I know sometimes it feels like it's milliseconds, but who wants to wait these days?
I was actually surprised that I could see a difference.
And guys, here we put both devices to the test and run Geekbench for single core, multi-core, and compute several times. As expected, the results are very, very similar. However, we did notice that the 8 GB version came out slightly higher every single time. The numbers are not mind-blowing compared to other devices out there. When comparing compute, we noticed that the 8 GB version comes out slightly lower. Nevertheless, it is really close and should not make a single difference. If you guys watched my previous video, you probably noticed that the FPS rate for Fortnite maxes out at 30 frames. In every setting, which was really kind of disappointing when I did the video. Well, you know what? This has been fixed now. Fortnite released an update last night, which makes it better use of graphics. And both devices do support 60 frames per second for low, medium, and high settings now. However, the question is, how do they perform, and is there a difference between both models when gaming? Both are set on high and 60 FPS. On the left-hand side is the 8 GB version, and to the right is 6 GB Tab S6 version. Now there are some interesting results here. Although both devices are set to 60 FPS, only the 8 GB version can come close to this. The other Tab S6 is struggling and dropping down to 25 frames per second when set on high. And you know what? When the graphics get even more intense, the 8 GB model struggles, has problems to keep up, and drops frame rates down to 30, sometimes 25, but jumps up very, very quickly to 60.
So how did you feel about the actual performance of the two?
I was surprised. I was surprised that 2 GB of RAM makes such a big difference, not just gaming-wise. It felt snappier when I was using it day in, day out today. It felt really snappy just opening up application. It kind of had that edge to it, if you like. And I would highly recommend to go with the 8 GB version. We're not sponsored by Samsung or anybody else. That is just the experience we have today.
And just from usage, it is much more enjoyable.
Absolutely. Jens here from Autospace.
Toni the car geek.
You know the drill. Like, subscribe. See you next time. Peace out.
Peace out.